Hello, and welcome to something a little different. I'm davidinark, and today I'm installing Windows 11 sneak peek leaked version. Whatever. Anyhow, I'm installing it on an i7-4770. It's an Acer, Aspire, and the version I have supposedly didn't have to have secure boot. However, I could not get it to load from the USB drive without enabling secure boot. So that's what I did right there, was just to jump in, install secure boot, and then all of a sudden it started loading from the USB flash drive. Now, it doesn't take very long, and the little Windows start or the installation menu pops up, looks just like Windows 10. So far that's not different, other than you see here, setup is starting, Microsoft Windows 11. Again, supposed to have the TPM bypassable install. That did not work. Now it wants me to activate Windows. So I grabbed a key that I had. It happened to work. So by the way, it was a Windows 10 key. So a Windows 10 key does work on at least the leaked version of Windows 11. I've got an 80 gig hard drive here, but it already had a partition, so I need to delete the partition that was there. You see, now we've got 74 and a half gigs free, and we can start the installation. Now, I also installed this in a virtual machine. You'll see that at the end, but I wanted to try this on real hardware and, frankly, some older hardware. This machine is from, I don't know, 2015 or something. Again, it's an i7-4770. It's 16 gigs of RAM, 12 gigs of RAM. I can't remember. Anyhow, once the process starts, then it takes a long time. This is actually, the sequences here have been shortened a little bit. I just kind of edited them down, because I didn't want to show you in real time just how long this took. It was insane. I don't know. I thought it'd be kind of fun to see what you get when you get the leaked, supposedly leaked version of Microsoft Windows 11. So here, this is after the first reboot, and it is giving us the familiar Windows 10 little spinning dots thing as it comes up. And so far, I mean, honestly, it just looks like Windows 10. I don't see anything different at this point. We even have the hey, just a moment, we're finishing up setting up. So by the way, there was no way for me to record this other than to record it with my phone propped up, so my apologies for the phone video, but it is what it is. Oh, here we go. Ah, new Windows logo. It's all flat squares. Great. All right, so is this the right country region? Oh, I like the spinning globe thing there with the airplane. Now, I noticed that it's got speakers in the lower, there's a speaker in the lower right corner. We also can move, up and down. The scroll bar is kind of cool. I was hoping that when you clicked on a different region, the globe would spin, but it didn't. So there you go. Anyhow, as you can see, there's speakers down here, and it actually is detecting my audio device. I'm not getting any sound out of my speakers. So after a little bit of playing around, I did manage to get some sound. And so now we can go through this. And here, I was not connected to the network at this time. I just wanted to see if you could set up without being connected to the network, which you'll see that worked here. It does not work in the virtual machine. I guess because this one does not have Wi-Fi, I don't know. But anyhow, at this point, it asked me for my name. It asked me to create a super memorable password. And, of course, answer a bunch of security questions. Yeah. After that is all done, Then, of course, we get the privacy settings. So other than the graphics on the left looking a little different, I don't think that's how they looked in Windows 10. It's been a while since I've set up Windows 10, so I don't think they're the same. We eventually get to where our system is getting things ready for us. Again, very Windows 10 looking. And so once that kind of goes away, now this is different. Although the text is the same, that background with that kind of warbly blue, and this is sped up right here. I don't think that was a Windows 10 thing. I believe this is new for the Windows 11 installation. And eventually we get this set up here and ba-ding, we have a new Windows sound. Ooh, and the Windows 11 desktop. Now, I'm going to assume that many of you have already seen Windows 11 sneak peeks or whatever from other people, so I'm not going to concentrate on a whole lot of things other than I love the rounded windows with the shadow behind them. Honestly, though, it's very reminiscent of Mac, but in any case, I will jump in here. I know a lot of folks like the dark. Look at that. Oh, privacy beep up there. As you can see here, the system currently has not detected my display adapter, and that is because I'm not connected to the internet at this point. So I decided to go ahead and plug in the internet. I clicked on the magnifying glass down there. You get this little pop-up window, which is like the Cortana replacement, basically. So I typed in control panel, and there we go with control panel looking like control panel has for many, many versions of Windows at this point. And then I also wanted to play around and just check out some of the sounds. So the sounds in Windows 11 have that kind of muted sort of tone to them. They're very soft, very friendly tones. This here allows you to create virtual desktops, which I'm pretty sure has been a thing in Windows for quite a while, but this here, it's right on the taskbar. So essentially what that lets you do is I can open up Edge on one desktop, bring up a virtual desktop number two, and I could do something else in it, or I could just close it down. So essentially it's like having separated workspaces where you can do different things. I'll be interested to see how that works in terms of gaming and that kind of stuff once Windows 11 is released. This here is the Windows dashboard, which I'm assuming is going to have things like weather and whatever. To me, it's kind of like that goofy widgets thing, way back in, like, I don't know, I don't even remember when that started, but I remember it being a pain in the butt, like in Windows 8. I'm sure even before that, I think XP may have had that too. I don't know. But here you see we've got new icons for representing the different pieces and parts. And so here, I'm just going to show that you're running the 4770. And right here, because I'm connected to the internet, the system is actually detecting my video card and installing the drivers as I'm trying to show you this. It's got 16 gigs. I thought it only had 12. Well, looky there. But you can see here, we're running Windows 11 Education, and it is the developer version. Ooh, ah. Here you can see it detected the Radeon HD 5470 with 1 gig of RAM. It is a low-end old video card, but it's the only one that I had handy. The other thing I want to show here is dark mode, because I know a lot of people are into dark mode now. It's 2021. That's the thing, has been for a couple of years, right? So the Windows 11 dark mode, just like you could do in Windows 10, frankly. So there you go. Look at there, another startup notification automatically installed the Catalyst Control Center. You can see dark mode here, just propagating through File Explorer. Notice at the bottom, the system tray. I thought this was kind of interesting. The radio buttons no longer have like a dot in the middle. Now they just kind of highlight blue around the edge. It's kind of weird. So then I thought I would jump into some games. And really, it turns out I end up playing just two games. One is Dorf Romantic. And what I want to show you here is just how slow this is behaving. I'm pretty sure a bulk of that is because of the video card, but it could also be the operating system in addition to this much older processor. After Dorf Romantic, I decided to really push the limits as far as what I think this machine could probably do and fire up Far Cry 3. This is all real time. This has not been slowed down. It's not been sped up. This is how awfully slow this was. As I move my mouse around, I'm moving my mouse regular. I'm not purposely going slow. I am purposely moving the mouse, trying to get it to do stuff, and it is painfully slow. Now, I've played Far Cry 3 on this machine, but I had a different video card, and I'm pretty sure that's where the hang-up is. Like I said, could also be whatever the overhead is for Windows 11, but here you see the cutscene for the introduction. You can just see how laggy it is, how many frames are being dropped. I mean, I don't have the FPS listed, but I mean, you can see it is just not behaving well at all, and just trying to work through the menus, trying to get it to do anything it's just chugging. It is really chugging. And then this is a quick little part right as you meet Voss, and you can see just how slow and awful this really is. Again, it's the video card is definitely part of the culprit, and I'm not sure how much of Windows 11 quote-unquote leaked version this is also coming to, coming into play. Could be a lot, could be none. You never know. One of the other cool things I found, though, is the maximize and minimize button in the upper right-hand corner of each window actually has layouts. Now, I apologize that this got cut off. I did not realize this was not on my camera as I was recording, but you'll see as I kind of play through here, those little boxes that pop up there in the upper right-hand corner, that lets you set where you want your windows to appear. So, I mean, overall, I think the Windows 11 experience is moving closer and closer toward more of a mobility option than anything else. Trying to kind of become one, I think Microsoft and Apple both have been moving in that direction for quite some time. This here is me installing and running Windows 11 in VirtualBox. I set that up with 4 gigs of RAM, an 80 gig virtual hard drive, and in this particular case, I disabled the network card, hoping that it would just kind of let me go through the install and call it good. However, it did actually force me to create a Microsoft account, or I could have logged in with one, but I wasn't doing that. I don't want Microsoft knowing what I'm doing. Oh, they already know what I'm doing. Who am I kidding? But anyway, it did force me to create a Microsoft account before I could do much of anything else. So it is what it is. But I will say it is spunkier in a virtual machine than it was on the actual i7-4770 hardware. Again, just walking through the setup pieces of this, and I just went ahead and made up a fake Microsoft account. Who cares? It's a throwaway account. It's not a fake account. It's just a throwaway account. But in any case, decided to throw that in there. And then as we go through this, of course, you've got the different privacy settings. Now, what was different in this version than in the, and I don't want to say version, but this install versus the install that I used on the i7, this install actually brought me to a screen where it asked me how I wanted to use the system. And this is a new, well, to me it's new anyway, a new installation in Windows 10, actually, it showed up. I was working on a friend of ours. I was working on their computer and getting everything reinstalled. And when I reinstalled Windows 10, it came up with that selection box as well, asking me, you know, how did they use their machine? I had not seen that before. Again, it's been a while since I installed Windows 10, so that was kind of different. It was, you know, so they're obviously carrying that into Windows 11 as well. One of the things that I didn't point out and I forgot until just now, you'll notice that the corners of the windows are all rounded, but that does not carry through a lot of the applications like File Manager, File Explorer, those types of things, until you get your video card drivers installed, and then you'll get the rounded corners on the various windows and dialog boxes, which I thought was kind of interesting that those don't show up until then. The other thing is when you click on the start button, you'll notice that in this particular case, it has been populated with various apps that presumably either come with Windows 11 or are going to be offered through OEM packages or what have you. So this one here is Photoshop Express, which is a free, very scaled down version of Photoshop. So that's something in there as well. But anyhow, just wanted to take a quick first look at Windows 11, the quote unquote leaked version. Thought I'd share that with you and just give some initial thoughts. It's going to be interesting to see what it does. I'm an old man, so I've been through pre-DOS days, up through DOS, and every iteration of Windows since the beginning. And I don't know, it's interesting. We'll see what this does. My concern, of course, as a YouTuber and gamer, is how is this going to affect gameplay, what kind of performance issues, what sort of other issues are we going to run into? For example, those of you that are maybe aware, when BeamNG updated to their latest main version, basically Microsoft is forcing companies to move user data out of the documents folder and into their app data folder, which is, I sort of understand, but I'm a person that believes all of your files, if they are user files, then they should be in the documents folder. Why would they not be? But anyhow, so Microsoft is pushing companies to move away from that, and I'm curious to see how that carries into Windows 11. So, and of course, other things, just general performance, network performance, all that kind of stuff. But anyhow, there you go. A first look at the quote-unquote leaked version of Windows 11. Hope you enjoyed this. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time.